هيا على الفلاح.
Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Once again, my beloved brothers and sisters, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulillahi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. We always praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We always send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his companions, his household, every one of you, every one of us, humanity at large. May Allah bless us all and guide us to the straight path and keep us on it steadfast right up to the end and grant us all Jannatul Firdaus. A unique Ramadan. This is a conference with a difference. It is an online conference and thousands of people are participating from across the globe or have already participated. My brothers, my sisters, this will definitely be a unique Ramadan, one to be remembered. There is a lot of hope. We do know on one hand that we have the coronavirus. We have people who are being affected on a daily basis and infected as well. And we have people who are losing their lives. People who are struggling to cope because of loss. Loss of all sorts of things, whether it is a job or finances or relationships or health or whatever it may be. Even the loss of the lives of loved ones. We do know that Allah is the most merciful, the most kind, the most generous, the most compassionate, the most forgiving, the most beneficent. Allah is the healer. He is the curer. He is the sustainer. He is the provider. He is the protector. He is the curer. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all cure. May He sustain us, protect us, provide for us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never forsake us. Ameen. My brothers and sisters, that having been said, there is a lot of hope. Many of us have started praying when we didn't used to pray. Many of us have changed the way we dress when that was not the case. Many of us have started reading the Quran when that was not the case. Many of us have taken our religion seriously when that was not the case before this particular situation. So isn't that a blessing in disguise? Every time there is something that happens that brings us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is indeed a blessing of Allah. It is indeed a sign of the mercy of Allah and His love for us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love us. May He have mercy on us. My brothers and sisters, a unique Ramadan, a one wherein we will not be able to do what we've been used to doing every Ramadan in the past. Insha'Allah, things will return to normal by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But something unique will be happening. We will be restricted when it comes to participation in the masjid. I'm sure we've heard speaker after speaker remind us of some of these challenges. However, my brothers and sisters, that does not mean ibadah is going to stop. It does not mean that tilawa is going to stop, meaning the recitation of the Quran or the worship of Allah. Nothing is going to stop. We will be reaching out to our loved ones, checking up on them, but this time via the phone, via the technology that Allah has provided us. I was sitting and thinking, imagine if this was to have happened in 1980. Or 1990, when we did not have the mobile devices, we did not have the internet, and technology was not as advanced. What would we have done? Subhanallah. Perhaps we would not be able to listen or participate in an online conference such as this one, the Light Upon Light conference, a unique Ramadan. However, this time, Allah has blessed us by holding back this coronavirus to a time where we now have technology and we have the internet. We have advanced technologically. So let's advance spiritually, religiously, and in our relationship with Allah. We should be at a very advanced stage. I promise you, my brothers and sisters, Access to knowledge has become easier than ever before, but unfortunately, access to falsehood is also very easy. Ways to do good and reach out to the rest of the world have now become so close to our fingertips, in fact, on our fingertips. However, ways to deviate have become equally close. So my brothers and sisters, it's up to us what we'd like to make of the coming month. We have to have hope. We have to instill hope. We have to believe in the mercy of Allah. We have to teach others about the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to understand that we will take every precaution that we can given the capacity that Allah has blessed us with. But with that, once we've done all of that, we lay full trust in Allah and we keep going. We keep doing what we have to. It's not all doom and gloom, my beloved brothers and sisters. It's a unique Ramadan. A Ramadan wherein we will be able to participate online more than ever before. So start selecting what you'd like to do in the month of Ramadan. Start setting your timetable, the lessons that you will engage in, the online correction of your recitation, the online learning, expanding of your knowledge of the Quran, the tafsir, the rulings, the regulations, that of the sunnah, the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, the rules and regulations of your religion. And let's not waste our time engaging in that which is futile and at times even destructive. My brothers and sisters, a unique Ramadan. We may not be able to gather with the extended family for the beautiful iftar tables that are laid, but we will be with our nuclear family, a smaller number. We will still enjoy iftar. Allah is still there for us, and Allah still has the blessed month of fasting for us. We will fast as best as we can, unless we have an excuse, obviously. Those who are unable to fast, like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to us, فَمَنْ كَانَ مَرِيضًا أَوْ عَلَى سَفَرٍ فَعِدَّةٌ مِّنْ أَيَّامٍ أُخَرٍ. Or, وَمَنْ كَانَ مَرِيضًا. Allah says, and the one who is unwell, unable for some reason or another, sickly or traveling and has an excuse. There are a few other excuses that have been expanded in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and in the explanation of the scholars of this particular verse and several narrations of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So if you fall in one of those categories, yes, you will be given a leeway. You may fast after Ramadan to make that up. And if you really cannot do that as well because of your age or because of some reason, your health, etc., you can give what is known as a fidya, which is a type of a charity, in order to compensate for the fasts that you would have missed. But my brothers and sisters, the month of Ramadan is still the most blessed month. It is coming to us with every blessing that it has always come with by the will of Allah. Nothing is going to be short. We will be praying in congregation, even if there are just two of us in the house. Let the husbands learn how to lead. Let the people learn how to lead. Let those in the homes learn how to follow. And let them learn how to be spending their time in the wisest possible way. Will we be gathering our family members and reading something? A good reminder? A good book? A book of hadith? A book of inspiration? Something written by the scholars for us to have mentioned a little bit of guidance, perhaps motivation? Will we do that? If the plan is that we are going to be doing that, good news to you. You will be spending your day in a very productive way. How much of the Quran have we decided to read? I think, and I definitely do think, this year we will have much more time to read the Quran. So don't waste your time on social media. Don't waste your time on applications that may be, subhanallah, in the transgression of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine sitting, engaging in one of the biggest sins that you can, while in the month of Ramadan, the month of mercy, the month of forgiveness, the month of freedom from hellfire. It is a unique Ramadan, but it is still Ramadan, subhanallah. So let's not engage in that which is sinful or futile. For example, those who lose track of the fact that they are within the month of blessings and do things that they're not even supposed to be doing outside that month, such as nude phone calls, perhaps on video, perhaps wasting time with pornography or something that is futile, chats that are X-rated and so on. Brothers and sisters, that's not the way of a believer. Not in the month of Ramadan and not outside the month of Ramadan. So let's seize this opportunity to cut out those bad habits, even if they're just online. In fact, I want to invite you to spend not just this unique month of Ramadan, but a lifetime within the obedience of Allah. There is a lot of time wasting that is happening on some of the applications on our phones. And the reason why I concentrate on the mobile phone is because all of us have the device and we're all using it either constructively or destructively or a bit of both. And sometimes there is more constructive use than destructive use. Sometimes there is more destructive use than constructive use. So how are you using your device and how do you plan to change that? Imagine I was sitting this evening and reading a beautiful verse of the Quran. And I was thinking to myself in Surah Al-Layl, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى. As for the one who gives, which means you're generous, what do you give? Do you give your neighbors? Do you give the poor? Do you reach out? Do you give charities? Just like we are giving unique charities where it's happening online, subhanAllah. Buttons and mashallah, swipe of a screen, etc., etc. The next thing, we've donated a few pounds, a few dollars, a few rands, whatever it may be, a few riyals, we've donated. In the same way, ask yourself, am I participating in goodness? Am I giving? Character, conduct, a smile, good word, all that is part of giving. You're giving. So whoever gives, and whoever is conscious of Allah, you need to do two things. Give and develop your relationship with Allah. You give and you develop your relationship with Allah. A'ta wa taqa. And you believe in the goodness, believe in heaven, believe in that which Allah has prepared. Believe in the mercy of Allah, the acceptance of Allah, the acceptance from Allah of your good deeds and the forgiveness of Allah. So Allah says, if you are giving and you are a generous person, and you have a good relationship with Allah, and you believe in the hereafter, in the goodness, etc., then you know what Allah says? We will make it easy for you to do good deeds. La ilaha illallah. Thank you so much for listening to this short message. I pray that it has increased you in a little bit of motivation and hope. And the same applies to all of us. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.